Hello students, welcome back to the BSc Third Sem Basic English course. I'm Dr. Vidya Patil, serving as Assistant Professor of English at Government First Grade Women's College, Bidar. In today's video, I will be discussing about the lesson Bleached Girls, India and its Love for Light Skin. In this lesson, we will be discussing about the obsession of Indians with regard to fair skin. We will try to explore the various reasons as to why Indians love fair skin and also try to understand how the markets have exploited this obsession of Indians for fair skin. So come on students, let us now begin with this video. As I've told you earlier, the title of this lesson is Bleached Girls, India and its Love for Light Skin. Are you obsessed with fair skin? If so, students, after reading this lesson, you will realize that it is high time we shrug off this discrimination. The authors of this lesson are Neha Mishra, who is an assistant professor of law at Rewa University of Bangalore, and Ronald Hall, who is the professor of social work at Michigan State University. The beauty parlors in India are constantly reminding girls that only fair skin is beautiful. They're constantly insisting on scrubbing out the tan. We also notice that the classified ads which are found on the Sunday newspapers emphasize on the fairness of the girls. We come across elderly aunties who are constantly advising young women to apply saffron paste, which will make their skin whiter and smoother. We constantly hear phrases or sentences such as, "She's so lucky that she got married in spite of her dark color." Such things are happening even today in 2021. But we can now see that the younger generation is pushing back against this phenomena. Aranya Johar, an 18-year-old girl who published Brown Girl's Guide to Beauty on YouTube on 7th July 2017, states this in her poem. This video is a spoken word poem, and the poem contains lines such as, "Forget Snow White, say hello to Chocolate Brown, I will write my own fairy tale." What Aranya Johar is trying to say here is that girls right from a very impressionable young age are told fairy tales such as Snow White, and it is imprinted on their mind that they need to become fair if they want to have a good future. But she says that now I'm going to write my own fairy tale and I don't need a fair skin for that. At around this same time, we find that a Bollywood actor, Nawazuddin Siddiqui, also tweeted certain remarks against the racist culture which is prevalent in the Indian film industry. He talks about how this profession, which relies on acting skills, chooses people on the basis of the color of their skin and their looks rather than on their talent. The authors also give us the example of actress Tanishta Chatterjee, who vehemently pushed back when she was bullied for her skin tone on a live TV show in 2016. Indians have an obsession with whiteness, which can also result into violence at many times. We hear of various cases which are reported of attacks on African students living in India because of this fear of black and brown skin. The next part of the lesson has been titled as the bleaching syndrome. In this part, the writers explain this obsession of Indians for the fair skin. Indian history can provide us various reasons as to why Indians love fair skin. Throughout the medieval and modern history, India was visited by various settlers and travelers, especially the Europeans from the 15th to the 17th centuries, such as the Portuguese, Dutch, and French. The Indian subcontinent has been invaded and ruled by the Mughals in the 16th century. It was colonized by the British and ruled by them from the 17th century until our independence in 1947. All these foreign visitors were of relatively fair complexion and claimed to be superior to us. As a result of being subjected to a succession of white overlords, that is, being ruled by people who are fairly white in color, Indians have for long associated fair skin with power, status, and desirability. In the present day, the contempt for brown skin is embraced both by the ruling class as well as the lower castes. So, this obsession for white skin is found in every section of the Indian society. Also, this contempt for the brown skin is reinforced by the beauty magazine covers, which mostly feature foreign models or excessively fair models. According to a study which was conducted on men and women from 2013 to 2016, more than 70% of the respondents interviewed said that they wanted to have a partner who was of fair skin. This colorism pushes Indians to lighten their skin and has created a phenomena called bleaching syndrome. This is not just a superficial fashion phenomena, but actually a deeply ingrained process which is taken place in our country. This bleaching syndrome is a strategy which reflects the deep set belief that the fair skin is more better, more powerful, and more beautiful than the brown skin. Skin bleaching is very common not only in India, but also in the rest of Asia and Africa. The next part of the lesson is titled A Thriving Bleaching Market. In this part, we will understand how the markets have exploited this obsession of Indians for the fair skin. A growing market of creams has cropped up to fill this demand for a fair skin. This market earns over $400 million every year. The most widely sold products include Femme, Lotus, Fair and Lovely, Fair and Handsome, etc. Most of these creams are made up of a dangerous cocktail of steroids, hydroquinone, and tretinoin. The long-term use of these can lead to health concerns like permanent pigmentation, skin cancer, liver damage, and mercury poisoning, among other things. A marketing study which was conducted in 2014 found that more than 90% of the Indian girls said that skin lightening was an important part of their beauty regime. These women overlook the after effects of bleaching. Initially, the focus of the fairness cream market was only on feminine beauty, but this market now caters to men also. Products which are marketed to men promise to fight sweat, give them fairer underarms, and make them attractive for women. The last part of the lesson is titled Bleaching Backlash. In this section, the writers try to tell us how the younger generation is trying to push back against this Indian obsession for fair skin. The Advertising Standards Council of India has issued guidelines in 2014 stating that ads should not reinforce negative social stereotyping on the basis of skin color. This guidance is in keeping with the Indian Constitution, which provides for equality of all, as mentioned in Article 14, and also prohibits discrimination on the grounds of religion, race, caste, sex, or place of birth, as mentioned in Article 15. Unfortunately, law can do very little to stop this subtle forms of racism and bigotry which is present in our society. This bleaching syndrome goes beyond skin color. Indian women are questioned at every step with regards to their hair texture and color, speech, their marital choices, their dress style, which raises real concerns about female esteem. As Aranya Johar's poem states, with the hope of being able someday to love another, let's begin by being our own first lovers. Now, we'll just listen to this poem of Aranya Johar, that is The Brown Girl's Guide to Beauty.
Since the age of 9, I've been slapping my face with fairness creams. Every face wash was a slap in the face because I was a skin tone which was ugly. My chest is too small for a girl who just hit puberty, and my skinny waist and unhealthy thigh gap was the only thing I wore confidently around. I had a voice and opinion, but they muted my sound, probably because I was told boys only like girls who were fair and lovely. My cousin brother starving himself because skinny abs were easier to obtain on a healthy diet. He read about active drink juice diets and decided he wanted to try it. All because there wasn't a single GQ or man's world that didn't have abs embossed. We forget that beauty for men also comes with a cost. And it asks for a penny for your thoughts, but I heard being healthy is wealthy, and it's both we've lost. I am the color of the strong fragrant tea. Auntie sips are nonchalantly remarking, Bipasha would be prettier if she was fair. The color of our skin dictates our beauty, and that's not the only thing that's unfair. When we brown girls revolt against our own deflections, every single time an Indian magazine puts a light-skinned girl on a cover calling her brown. I asked my mother to get me healthy, yellow paste over yellow paste, because anything is better than brown, anything is better than dark. Only light-skinned with European features are considered odd. My friend's face is covered with cream more than his girlfriend's kisses. He flinches every time she says she accepts him for his true colors. How do I teach him to embrace the color of his skin when she keeps gifting him fairness creams, his daily baptism with sunscreen to protect him from suntans, men lathering themselves to the same behind closed doors because apparently being insecure makes you less of a man. When I was asked to be an ideal body type, I was taught they want the curvy cheek but not the cellulite. They want the big butt but not the thick thighs. They want the dog small but the waist smaller. They want the heart big but the chest bigger. And often women of gender reiterate these thoughts, but you see, it's internalized. It's what we've been taught. So I asked my ma, instead of looking for grooms who are fair, let's look for grooms who treat people fairly. Because the color of someone's skin is what we should consider when we look to marry. Virtues, belief, opinion and decisions scale larger than a stand on a fairness scale. Forget Snow White, say hello to chocolate brown, I'll write my own fairy tale. There isn't a single person who isn't pulled apart by these expectations. Brown girls struggle getting the right foundation. Boys constantly doing weight calculations. We're all more than our coloration and body types, because you and I, we're all alike. With the hope of being able to someday love another, let's begin by being our own first lovers. Because people aren't made to fit or custom made, it's time we realize love comes in all shapes and shades. It's time we love all shapes and shades.
The poem which you just heard makes you realize that how essential it is for us to discard this obsession for fair skin. Reading this lesson will have given you an idea about how or why Indians love fair skin, how the markets have exploited this obsession of Indians, and how the younger generation needs to fight back against this obsession. I'm sure, students, that this lesson will prove to be an eye-opener for all of us. I hope you like this video. Thank you.